welcome tonight. Goes to someone who spent most of her career writing editorials for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, winning the Pulitzer Prize for commentary. Please welcome the video for Cynthia Tucker.
Monica Pearson. is always a necessary part of enlightenment. Cynthia Tucker, through her copious research and incisive writing, cut to the core of issues that made her readers squirm, scream, or support, but all were enlightened as she stirred the pot. That was her job for 17 years as the editor of the editorial page of first the Atlanta Constitution and then the combined Atlanta Journal-Constitution. She was the first woman and the first African-American to hold that position, 24 years after Harmon Perry became the first African-American reporter on either paper. Cynthia had no problem telling the truth about racial stereotypes, expressing concerns about the erosion of voting rights, and pointing out the ineffectiveness and the inadequacies of African-American leaders as well as white leaders. No one escaped her scrutiny. No one was untouchable. As the old folks used to say, Cynthia always told the truth and shamed the devil, no matter what color, position, or ideology. Because of that, she was nominated for the Pulitzer Prize in 2004 and 2006. She won it in 2007 for, quote, her courageous, clear-headed columns that evince a strong sense of morality and persuasive knowledge of her community. Cynthia grew up watching her community change from segregated to integrated in Monroeville, Alabama. It's also the home, as you saw in the film, of Pulitzer Prize winner Harper Lee, the author of To Kill a Mockingbird. But it's also the hometown of an educator, Marva Collins. Cynthia grew up in a home of educators. Her mother was an English teacher, her father was a principal. Both gave her a strong sense of self and an example of excellence. She needed that when at the age of 16, she went to her first integrated school and then to Auburn University. After graduation, she became a reporter, first at the Atlanta Journal, then the Philadelphia Inquirer. She was a freelance writer, and then she came back to Atlanta, to the Journal, as a columnist and editorial writer. She was a Nieman Fellow at Harvard University, and in 2002, the American Society of Newspaper Editors gave her the Distinguished Writing Award for Column Writing, and the National Association of Black Journalists in 2006 named her Journalist of the Year. Those who worked with her at the AJC saw her as intelligent, articulate, thoughtful, and fair as she led the editorial board. Former columnist Jim Wooten wrote in 2011 about Cynthia, quote, for probably more than 20 years, we've disagreed. Yet the disagreements were very Southern, always civil, always polite, never personal. He went on to write, while Cynthia could elect to edit my column or not, after the editorial boards merged, she never once made a revision that changed tone, content, or meaning. As a colleague, she sometimes offered friendly, constructive suggestions, and more often than not, I took them. But the choice always was mine. She is a well-raised Southern girl of good heart and considerable talent who has enjoyed great success in the business, as the Pulitzer attests. And just as Wooten retired from the newspaper, so did Cynthia. But she was rewired as a professor at the University of Georgia, the Grady School of Journalism and Mass Communication. She taught persuasive writing. She helped young journalists find their voice and use it. But taking on that position gave Cynthia pause. Charlene Hunter Gall said Cynthia was nervous because she was worried since, quote, she didn't know how to write a syllabus, how to interact with students, how to navigate faculty politics. Cynthia had questions. How would students address her? How could she motivate students who were not doing their work? Was her grading system too lenient or too harsh? Luckily, a former editor from the AJC who was here tonight, Valerie Boyd, already was at UGA, and and she helped her friend Cynthia settle into her role of professor. She was excellent at it. Cynthia has now settled into the role of the wife to Dr. Johnson Haynes and mom to Carly in Mobile, Alabama. She still appears on radio and television as a commentator and is reachable through CynthiaTucker.com, Twitter, and Facebook. She describes herself as a journalist, a professor, and a progressive. I describe her as the conscience of a generation. Ladies and gentlemen, Cynthia Tucker.
Monica, thank you so much for that very lovely tribute. Although I have said to friends of mine that when you are inducted into a Hall of Fame, it's a certain sign that you're getting older. I remember when the National Association of Black Journalists made me a pioneer. I thought, oh my goodness. I do want to say thank you to the Atlanta Press Club for this tremendous honor. I also want to say thank you to my friends and former colleagues who are here with me this evening to celebrate. I had some awesome colleagues at the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, people who were hardworking, loyal, supportive, and did their best to keep me out of trouble. They didn't always succeed, but they tried. I also have several friends here this evening who are not journalists, but who have been very loyal, loving friends for many, many years. And being a friend of mine wasn't always the easiest thing because I was always stirring things up a little bit. I was Neil Gortz's favorite subject. Two or three times a week. There was that time that the Fox host that you just saw, what's his name? The Fox. Bill O'Reilly said two people to ambush me in my driveway. And I immediately called my colleague and friend Jay Bookman and I said, you will not believe what happened to me. So I am grateful to my friends and colleagues, and I would be remiss if I didn't mention my dear friend Valerie Boyd, who got to be through many years of teaching at the University of Georgia. I ended up loving being in the classroom, but I could not have done it without her. I am in tall cotton tonight, as we say in these parts. I am being honored along with some extremely talented journalists, and I am being inducted into a Hall of Fame that already has many, many very talented and noteworthy people. I am so honored to be here. And I needed this right now. I am still writing a syndicated column and I'm thinking about returning to the classroom. But I have been struggling over the craft to which I have given my adult life. I wonder whether journalism is still a powerful force for good. I wonder whether my industry has become too easily manipulated by bright, shiny objects that turn out to be fool's gold. We know now that there are foreign governments dedicated to manipulating not only American news consumers, but also American journalists. And sometimes we have fallen for their ploys. But getting this honor has reinvigorated me. It has reminded me that every age has charlatans who must be exposed, propaganda that must be uncovered, and lies that must be revealed. And I know that my colleagues, many of whom are in this room tonight, are up to the challenge. Thank you so very much for honoring me.